Usually you get to see just Natalia standing on this stool, but today you get to see Andrew. I wanted to relate something humorous. A few weeks ago, we had a baptism. Everybody was there, and it was hot, and we were all watching. Now, the Bible says, train up a child in the way that he should go, right? Why? Because they learned from us what we say. If we're hypocrites, they learn that we're hypocrites. And so Andrew was looking very carefully as John was baptizing people. And so a couple days ago, he decided to baptize Isaac. Isaac was not aware of this. He was not a willing participant. And he dunked him down. And I am, I don't know if I'm happy to say, but he was baptized by immersion. For several seconds until we realized, hey, let go of him, you know, and bring him back up. Isaac was not too happy about that. So, anyways, Andrew is watching. Natalia's watching. And the little ones, they are watching. And they may not say a whole lot, but they are watching. And they hear and they see everything, which is why the Bible admonishes us to train them up. Because if we're hypocrites, they'll see through it, right? All right. All right, go on down. Go sit down. Second part, I got something that kind of challenged me, and I want to also pass it on to you guys. I was listening to a song the other day, and the song had a really good chorus. It was talking about a man who was in town. He was doing some business, and while he was in town doing business, there was this commotion. And this man, this younger guy, comes running past him, and he kind of stops and puts his hands on his knees to kind of catch his breath. And he says, what's going on? He says, did you see a crippled man run past here? He says, no. He says, well, Jesus is down the street a couple blocks, and this crippled guy, he got touched. He's running home right now to tell his family about, you know, what all the good things that's been happening to him. And so as the song progresses, the guy said, well, I kind of find that hard to believe. He said, well, you know, the mute guy, he's telling everybody the wonderful works of Jesus to anybody who will listen to him. The deaf girl, she's hearing it. But he said, but if you don't believe me, he said, ask the blind man. He saw it all. The reason I mention that is when Jesus was walking here on this earth, right, he operated in full power, 100% success. And I was thinking, okay, I want to have that. I mean, that should be our ultimate goal of where we're pressing toward, of where, you know, Jesus, he was not hindered. The only time that the Bible ever records that he was hindered was in his hometown because of the unbelief that was present there. Okay, not even he could overcome that. So he just walked away. And, you know, where somebody had just the tiniest ounce of, you know, with a man who came up and said, you know, help my unbelief, Lord, help me. And Jesus said, I can work with that. And so that challenged me where, you know, I was, okay, if the crippled can run around, the mute can speak, the deaf can hear, and the blind can see it all, that's what we should be striving. That's what I want in my life. And then corporately, that's what we also want happening here as well. Amen. Amen.